Hello again, this is LaZouche Custom here. Okay, a few of you have been asking me recently how do I go about painting the metal furniture or parts on your gas blowback pistols. Well, there's different stages to go through in order to get it to a finished painted look, and the major components that you'll need obviously are your undercoat, which is white primer, metal undercoat. You can get red primer and grey, I think, as well, but I usually stick with the white. You can buy these at any DIY store, or car auto store, or whatever. Then you need the paint, the spray paint that you're going to have as your finish coat, i.e. this one's going to be silver, or you can have black, matte black, gloss black, or in the case of this pistol, it was silver on the furniture. But you could also go for the blue if you wanted to have the furniture actually match the pistol colour. It's entirely up to you. If you want to finish coat it, i.e. not leave it matte black, or you want to get a good tough coating on it if it's silver or a coloured colour or gloss, then go for a clear lacquer. This will give you a good protective coating on the outside and hopefully stop it chipping too badly. I will hasten to add that you will not stop wear or chipping on painted parts. It is just simple as that. There is no way around it, especially on the grip safety, on the thumb safety, maybe not so much on the slide lock. Triggers and especially the mag catch, they will wear after a time, and the hammer, because they're the parts that you're using the most, so they will wear. There is nothing you can do about it. All I will say is it all comes down to the preparation to see or to get the maximum wear time out of it. So, if you want your part to be painted, what you first need to do is sand it down. Now, hopefully you can see under this light. I don't think you can. There we go. As you can see, I've left a key, which is what the paint will adhere to. So this originally was polished. I now want it to be sprayed black, by the way. So what I do is I just sand it down. You can use, well, 120 grade or 60 grade, any grade you want really, but so long as the score lines on there, the key that's left on the polished metal, is enough that it won't show up when it's got a coating of paint on it, but it's enough that the paint will adhere to it, because that is your key. That's the way the paint grips to the piece of metal that it's being sprayed onto. Also, another tip is around the edges of parts, just sort of wear them in a bit, i.e. sand them down so that they're rounded and not too sharp, because a sharp edge will chip a hell of a lot easier than what a slightly rounded or sanded off edge will. So just think about that when you're doing it. Okay, so that's your preparation. Here's thumb safety that has been, well, fairly well prepared. Yes, you can still see black on it. The reason being, this is a custom safety. It's been made out of a standard 1911 A1 actual unit, but with a MEU thumb pad from the right-hand side of an MEU grip safety, which I've turned into a single. Instead of throwing that piece away, I've cut them off and glued and pinned them, as you can see, there's the little pin mark there, glued and pinned them to this, cut off the original pad, obviously. Now, this is going to be black, so it doesn't really matter about sanding it down, although I have a little bit, as you can see, there's a bit of a score mark on there, just to give it a key, so that when it is sprayed, it will take. Now then, using your white primer, using this, you will then do your first coat onto the piece that's going to be sprayed. Now this one has had an even coat all the way over, not too much, but just enough that it covers the metalwork. I haven't bothered about this side because this eventually will be black. So if it's going to be silver, all you need to do is just polish up the end. You don't even have to spray the end because it will stay polished, because that section isn't actually touched by your fingers or worn that much, so you can just leave that polished. This side obviously will need to be sprayed silver. And here's one I prepared earlier. This is the third stage. This is where you've sprayed it matte black or silver or whatever colour you want. I've then gone over this with a clear lacquer, a clear lacquer spray. So it just gives it a bit more of a nice finish to it, and hopefully will wear a bit better, i.e. it won't chip so badly, because that lacquer sort of bonds the paint to the metal a bit better. If you want it left matte, that's fair enough. Matte doesn't chip so badly either, so you can just leave it that colour if you want. I wanted these slightly a glossy finish to them, because the pistols that they're going to be going on require that finish. Actually, this is the one from my Nighthawk T3 compensated pistol, so it needed to have a little bit of a gloss sort of finish to it. So that's the three stages, or four stages if you count the polishing beforehand. The three stages, four stages that you go through to get to the finished painted stage. Now, you can do it for any of the parts, from the trigger, from the mag catch, slide stop, thumb safety, grip safety, hammer, any parts you want, even the grip screws if you so wish, the barrel bushing, anything you can use that's metal, you can spray up using that technique. So all you do is you sand it, do a key, i.e. leave it like rough. If you're gluing parts together like that, then obviously do a key, but you can leave the parts black if they're going to be black. Doesn't really matter. If they're going to be silver, then it needs all of the black paint taken off of them and a key done or whatever. Then you do one coat or a light coat of white undercoat or primer. It can be grey, can be red, depending on what you can get hold of. Then you do your top coat of either silver or black or whatever colour you want. And then if you want to finish it off, then you just do a top coat of clear lacquer. Should come up like that. As I say, you can do it for any parts. Now, these two grip safeties have been fitted to pistols in the past, as you can see, they're a bit worn here and there. This was done without an undercoat. It's an old grip safety. It's one of the first ones I ever sprayed up, actually. It's not worn too badly, to be quite honest, but it does give you an idea of how badly it can wear or chip easily if you don't do a key or an undercoat, or even do a lacquer coat over the top, which none of this has been applied to. This it's just purely a silver spray paint straight over the top of polished metal. As you can see, it's chipped, it's started to wear away. Also, you can see the metal underneath it. It's like giving it a dull sheen to it, although under this light it looks quite shiny, but it isn't, I assure you. It's worn on the edges, around the edges here have chipped. Hopefully you can see this on the video, if this camera will focus in. But yeah, so it's not too bad. It's done better than some. I mean, some of them have had huge patches that are missing. So that's just an idea, to give you an idea as to what not to do, really. But remember, you know, it's a learning curve. This was done a number of years ago before I realised what to do. This one, on the other hand, has been sprayed. Has been keyed, i.e. polished. A key left on it, then it's been undercoated, then black spray coated, and then lacquered. And as you can see, there is no, or at least hardly anywhere on that at all, apart from a slight chip there, which I think was done fairly recently, and quite usually by a piece of metal or something just digging into it. But actual fair wear and tear with your hands gripping it, whatever, there is no wear, none whatsoever. So this has turned out pretty good, so I'm quite chuffed with that. On the other hand, with black parts, black furniture, if you want to get the true sort of dulled metal black finish to them, then the best way to do it is cold bluing. Now, a friend of mine, he is going to be, hopefully over the next few weeks or whatever, experimenting by doing cold bluing, or will be in the future. And he's hopefully going to get back to me as to how it turns out. Now, I'm actually sort of vying as to whether I might do it myself anyway. So when I say cold bluing, you can buy solutions, different solutions are available by different manufacturers online, which all it does is it just darkens down metal surfaces. You have to do a key first and get rid of all of the grease off of the piece of metal that you're going to cold blue. So let's say it was the grip safety, you would literally sand it all down or whatever, get rid of all the grease marks, but leave a polished, and absolutely polish it up to a fine coat, so it's literally as if you can see your face in it. Literally, the more polished the better, but do it whilst wearing gloves, because then that way you won't get any grease on it or whatever. All the grease must be removed. That's the silicone oil, anything that might be on it, finger oil, whatever, must be got rid of it, because otherwise the bluing process won't work as well. Once you've done that, apply the bluing, you leave it for a little while, it slowly eats into the metal, then you just buff it up and polish it off, and it leaves it a deep sort of blue finish to it. Now, it won't be as good as the proper real steel bluing process, because proper bluing is done through heat. Obviously we can't do that with pot metal because it will just melt. In fact, I'm still not sure as to whether pot metal parts can be cold blued. Maybe you guys have already done it out there, I don't know. If you have, please comment below, let the rest of us know. As I say, this channel is set up for swapping hints and tips and information on any of the subjects I cover. So as I say, so hopefully in the future I'll be covering that in a little more detail as and when I get a pot of this cold bluing stuff myself. But, as I say, for a final sort of coat or whatever, here's one that I did for my Nighthawk T3. This is just sprayed again, spray painted black. I've done the end as well. It's not too bad. It's worn a little bit on the end there, obviously, because you're when you're stripping the slide down or whatever, you're always hitting that, so it will chip. This area is the only area that's really going to wear on here, and possibly the little nub piece there that goes up and locks against the slide. But the rest of it doesn't really wear that much. There's a little bit of wear along the edge, but other than that, it's done pretty good. So I'm quite chuffed with that. So as I say, the secret is key it, undercoat it, and then do a top coat and then a lacquer coat. That's the key if you're going to spray parts. But as I say, in the future I'll be going over the cold bluing process, so hopefully that might be a bit better for black parts. You can't do that for silver, it's only for black. But there you are, so that's what it will look like if it's sprayed properly. As I say, this has been had a lacquer coat on it, as you can see, or at least hopefully you might be able to see it a bit more on here actually. No, it's hard to tell, but this one has had a lacquer coat, this one hasn't, but as you can see, it's beginning to wear, this one, and this one was done roughly around the same time. This one hasn't worn at all, although I don't use this gun that often, but it hasn't worn that much. So, it proves that a lacquer coat and a good keying process and undercoat works a hell of a lot better. So there you go. So, that's the major stages you go through for painting metal parts. As I say, you will need a decent primer. Obviously the top coat, whatever it's going to be, whether it's like this one is silver, but you can have black, blue, pink, whatever colour you want really. But then a top coat of clear lacquer will just help to seal it in and give it a bit of a tougher coating for general wear and tear. But overall, it will chip. There is no way around it, because they're parts that get used by your, you know, by you, they're touched more often by you with your gloves on, whatever, they'll brush against holsters and so forth, so they will get chipped. There is nothing else you can do to stop it, it just happens. So, you know, be prepared for in a year or so's time, when it's looking a bit tatty, then you'll have to strip it down again and repaint it. So just be aware of that. But if it's just going to be display model or used now and again, then yeah, it's a good process to do it, then spray it, like how I do. It doesn't take long anyway to respray it again afterwards. Just strip the part out, sand it down again. And there you go, away you go. Okay, so hopefully that will give you some ideas as to what to do. If you've got any questions or any queries other than what I've already expressed in the video, then please comment below. And I'll try and answer your questions as quick as I can. Okay, thanks very much for watching. And this is LaZouche Custom saying stay safe. Stay sharp, but stay safe. It's late in the night, by the way, when I'm doing these videos, so that's why I'm a bit tired at the moment. Anyway, all the best, guys, and see you next time. Bye for now.